Welcome to the Blazor Rich Text Editor tutorial. Here, I will show you how to import and export HTML files in the Syncfusion Blazor Rich Text Editor component. First, let me open an existing Blazor app, where I've added the Syncfusion Blazor Rich Text Editor component with the bind value property, bound to the HTML string. Also, I have customized the toolbar items on RTE. If you want to learn how to get started with the Blazor Rich Text Editor component, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. You can also find this example by following the link provided in the description below. Let's run the example application. As you can see, the RTE component rendered with provided HTML content. Also, you can see the toolbar with defined items. Next, I will show you how to import to HTML file in the Blazor RTE component. It allows you to load an external HTML file into the editor's content, which contains text with styling and images. First, I will create a custom toolbar item for an import button. To do this, I'll define the Rich Text Editor Custom Toolbar Item tag inside the Rich Text Editor Custom Toolbar Items tag, with the name property set to import. Then I'll update the toolbar item inside the tools list, which display the import icon. Within the custom toolbar item section, I'll set up a template section containing a Syncfusion Blazor uploader component with specific attributes like ID, show file list, and a CSS class for styling. If you want to learn more about adding the Blazor uploader component to a Blazor app, please check the documentation link and watch the video provided in the description below. Next, I'll establish the controller class to handle the import functionality. I'll create a class named SampleDataController within the data folder. I'll inherit from the controller base class, which is part of the ASP.NET Core framework. I'll mark it as an API controller, indicating its role in managing data flow between the UI and the application. Inside this class, I'll declare a private variable of type iWebHostEnvironment, which stores information about the hosting environment. Then, I'll create a constructor with the same name as the class to provide information about the hosting environment. Next, I'll create the import method. Before creation, I'll set the HTTP POST attribute, which specifies that the method should respond to HTTP POST requests. Then, I'll set the root attribute named import. This attribute sets the root for this action to import relative to the controller's base root. Now, I'll create the public method named import, which takes a parameter of type iFormFile named uploadFiles. iFormFile is used for file uploads in ASP.NET Core. Inside the method, I'll check if the uploadFiles parameter is not null, ensuring that a file has been provided in the HTTP request. I'll read the content of the uploaded file into a string using a stream reader. Additionally, I create the extract body content method, which returns the body content if the tags are found, otherwise, it returns the original HTML string. Afterward, I call this extract body content method to retrieve the HTML content. Furthermore, a method named sanitizeHTMLString will be created, employing regular expressions to eliminate non-printable ASCII characters and control characters from the input string. Finally, I'll sanitize the HTML content by applying the sanitizeHTMLString method. Upon completion, I'll add the sanitized HTML content to the response headers with the key RTE value. Next, I'll navigate to the index file. I defined the uploader async settings inside the Syncfusion Blazor uploader component. I'll set the save URL property to correspond to the import action method in the sample data controller. This attribute specifies the URL where the uploaded file will be sent for processing on the server side. Then, I'll define the uploader events tag to define events for the Syncfusion uploader component and set the success event. In this event, I'll bind the event handler responsible for handling the import HTML files. To do this, I'll create the public async method named onSuccess, which takes a success event args parameter. Inside the method, I'll retrieve the headers from the response property of the args object and convert them into a string, storing them in the headers variable. Then, I'll split the header string based on the substring root value and store the result in the header array. Finally, I'll assign the first part of the header array to a variable named HTML string. Additionally, I'll invoke an asynchronous method to notify Blazor that the component state has changed and needs to be re-rendered. Afterward, I'll bind the onSuccess method to the success event. Next, I'll define the uploader buttons tag and set the browse property, which is added with an empty string. Subsequently, I'll apply CSS styles to customize the appearance of various elements related to exporting and importing functionality. Look now, you can observe the import icon in the toolbar item. Upon clicking the input icon and browsing the HTML content from my local file, you'll notice the HTML content displayed in the Rich Text Editor component. Next, I will demonstrate how to export HTML files from Blazor Rich Text Editor. It allows users to take the content they've created or edited in the editor and save it as HTML. Here, I am going to display a button that enables you to export to an HTML file with a simple click. I already installed the Syncfusion Blazor button NuGet package. To achieve this, I am using the Syncfusion Blazor button's component namespace. I'll add one more Rich Text Editor custom toolbar item tag with the name property set to export. Then I'll update the toolbar item inside the tools list, which display the export icon. Within the custom toolbar item section, I'll define the Syncfusion Blazor button component and bind its onClick event. In this event, I will bind the event handler responsible for handling the export to an HTML file. To achieve this, I create a public method named downloadFile. Inside the method, I will create the HTML files using Word document. I have already installed the doc.io NuGet package. So I'm including the syncfusion.io namespace, enabling the creation of HTML files. Then, I create a public method named getDocument of type WordDocument, which takes an HTML text as a parameter. This method returns a WordDocument object. Initially, I create a new WordDocument object named document. Then, I create a variable named section of type interface section, assigned to the WordDocument using the addSection method to write text to the stream. Subsequently, I create another variable named paragraph of type interface paragraph, assigned to the section using the addParagraph method. Afterward, the content of the paragraph is set using the append HTML method of the paragraph interface, appending the HTML content passed as a parameter. Finally, I return the WordDocument object. Moving on, inside the downloadFile method, I check if the HTML string is not null. Subsequently, I invoke the previously created getDocument method to acquire a WordDocument representation of the provided HTML content. Simultaneously, I initialize a new memory stream named stream to temporarily store the HTML content. Then, I proceed to save the document to the stream in HTML format. Following that, I will create the JavaScript function that can be used to save a file with a given file name and base64 encoded content. To do this, I navigate to the host cshtml file. Inside the body tag, I define the script tag and create the function named saveAsFile. Within the function, I check if the browser supports the msSaveBlob method, typically true for Microsoft Edge. If the browser is Edge, it converts the base64 encoded content into binary data, creates a blob with the binary data, and saves it using msSaveBlob in the navigator. If the browser is not Edge, it creates a downloadable link with the specified file name and base64 encoded content, appends it to the document's body, triggers a click on the link to initiate the download, and then removes the link from the document. Following that, I navigate to the index file. I create the public async method named saveAs, taking three parameters, JavaScript interop, file name, and binary data. Inside the method, I invoke the created JavaScript function saveAsFile using the invoke async method. This JavaScript function is expected to exist on the client side, and I pass two arguments, filename and binary data converted into a base64 encoded string. Then, I declare the property named JS runtime of type IJS runtime. It is an interface in Blazor used for interacting with JavaScript code from .NET code. Moving on, inside the download file method, I check the JS runtime is not null. I utilize the saveAs method to store the exported HTML file locally. Finally, I close the document, flush the stream to ensure any buffered data is written to the file, and dispose of it to free up resources. Lastly, I bind the download file method to the onClick event of the button component and set the CSS class property. Moreover, I set the enableXHTML property to true. This property ensures valid XHTML format for the content look. Look now, you can see the export button in the toolbar item. First, I import an HTML file from my local system. Now I proceed to add various types of content such as hyperlinks, tables, and lists. To achieve this, I start by inserting hyperlinks and setting them to Syncfusion ebook links, providing the necessary names. Following that, I create a table and populate it with content. Additionally, I include an unordered list showcasing Syncfusion components. Once the content is prepared, I click the export button. You'll notice that the HTML file is promptly downloaded by the browser. Upon opening the downloaded file, you'll see all the added contents neatly arranged within the HTML file. Now let me summarize the key takeaways from this video. I covered how to import and export HTML files in Blazor Rich Text Editor component. For more information on the RTE's features, check out the documentation link provided in this video's description. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.